Do you like walking? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And do you like to bicycle? Mm-hmm.
Malta has a very high modal split towards the car. 84% of travelers use the car for their main trip. Maltese don't really do much walking or cycling. There are plenty of challenges and opportunities for active travel in the island of Malta. Malta is very small, an even smaller urban area, which is very dense and very active. And much of the people travel very short distances. The average commute is less than 6 kilometers. So we're really talking about travel that can easily be shifted to active travel modes.
I like to cycle since I find it a very effective way to beat the traffic. Since we have lots of cars here in Malta, it also gives me this great feeling of the independence, which I had from a very early age, when compared to people who would say they get independence when they're 18 and they going to get their driving license, which then they will get stuck in traffic anyway.
Actually, I don't cycle a lot yet because I'm still trying to get used to the traffic and the cycle lanes in Malta and also the hills. But when I cycle, I feel really free. And it gives me just this feeling of independence that I used to have in the Netherlands, actually, where I'm from.
So I prefer walking, basically because I feel responsible. I don't want to add another car on this small island. Before I used to use the bicycle as well, but now because of him, it's a little bit difficult.
I am Maria Attard. I'm a professor of geography and the director of the Institute for Climate Change and Sustainable Development here at the University of Malta. We have been developing a network of totem poles that have information about active travel. And so we identify destinations and we estimated travel time. And these totems provide information to users that want to engage with active travel. And in doing so, we encourage by providing more realistic information about the actual distance it takes for people to travel. So we're now extending west and we're extending north of the island and creating this nice network of safe walking and cycling routes between localities.
I am Anthony Chircop. I am the president of the Consiglio Regionale Il Vant, or the eastern region of Malta. When Active Travel Totem project was presented to us, immediately it came to our attention. The board, which I was a member of the board, was totally in favor of such initiatives. And that is why we went ahead to assist as best as we could.
The Active Travel Totems, I've recently discovered them and I've tried them out with the scanner. I think it's a good idea because a lot of people, they are not really aware of like the small streets and the routes. When I usually use Google Maps, like even when I came here, it was sending me through one ways and this type of stuff. It's not very safe and you don't want to be that cyclist that is in the way.
One of the most important aspects about the Active Travel Totems is the awareness nurturing aspect of them, because they raise this awareness of how far and how long it would take you to walk or to cycle to a particular place. Because in Malta, we are used to reaching for our cars and knowing how long that would take us by car, which is unpredictable. And these Active Travel Totems, they help you remove that uncertainty and raise this awareness of how long it would actually take you.
When we installed the first set of totems, the first five totems, we saw huge engagement from the community, not only on campus, but also outside. Just after a few months, we got over 25,000 clicks in terms of information or accessing the routes. And so we are very positive that this will increase engagement and nudge people into walking and cycling more.
I think to promote walking, policymakers need to put themselves in our shoes. More things need to be done to facilitate walking from an infrastructural point of view. More pavements, more areas where you can cross safely.
We don't have dedicated infrastructure or much dedicated infrastructure for cycling, and the walking infrastructure is not well maintained. And unless there is a significant investment in infrastructure for walking and cycling, that will remain the major challenge, major barrier.
Local councils should promote and ensure to facilitate and educate as necessary, so that the cars are not the owners of the road, that the road needs to be shared by different modes of alternative transport.
From the side of the government, there are various steps which must be taken to actively promote active travel, such as updates to the legal framework, so the law is on the side of pedestrians and bicycle users, updates to the policy framework, because so far Malta doesn't have a national cycling policy. Updates to the infrastructure, because the infrastructure is lacking in Malta. And finally, I would say, whoever does it needs to promote it as well, so other people can feel inspired to do so as well.